Hello everyone, welcome to this PNP webcast. Our topic of today is programming modern pages with some of the new features for modern pages being added recently. So currently modern pages support multiple zones, and in a zone you can have sections or columns. There's an option to create news pages to promote a page as being a news page, etc. So several new things have appeared in modern pages, and this webcast is showing you how to kind of create those and consume those in a programmatic way. My name is Bert Janssen. I'm a service engineer at Microsoft, and my co-host today is Vesa Juvonen.
Yep, my name is Vesa Juvonen. I'm a senior program manager from SharePoint Engineering as well. And like Bert mentioned, all of this is relatively new. It came and it was announced in the May event in 2017, early 2017. When we're recording this, this is relatively new stuff, depending on when you're watching the video, is it new or not. But really the key point of this one is to show you the different options, how to manage the sections, the zones, adding content, how to define the homepage for a site, a modern homepage for a site, or how to define an existing page to be a news using then CSAM APIs. And we use the PNP CSAM extension for doing that, which will then, let's say, abstract the complexity behind of actually doing this without, well, complexity of actually doing this. So the PNP site score will help significantly on making this happen. Yes. But Bert, please
absolutely.
Take it away.
Yeah, so it's indeed, you already mentioned this is PNP Sitescore functionality. So the API is in PNP Sitescore. So you need to use the version, at least the August 2017 version of PNP Sitescore in order to do the demo that I will show you later on in this webcast. Now, important thing to know is that we're going to kind of extend, built upon a previous webcast. So in March 20th, we released our Programmatically Creating and Updating Modern Pages webcast, which shows the basics, how to create a page, how to put a web part on a page. Back then, there was like a page had a single zone, so you had only one place to put a web part on. But if you want to learn everything, I think I would recommend checking out this webcast to get the basics. Now, in here, as already mentioned in the introduction, our focus is on the recently added components like zones, sections, and support for news and home pages. This will be a demo only webcast. So this was the last slide, actually. So let's immediately flip to our demo.
Quickly on the context, when you're flipping on the demo side as well. So this is also highly usable if you are, for example, want to upgrade existing classic SharePoint sites to have a modern experience. Because obviously you can enable the modern lists, modern pages experiences in classic sites as well. And now you that you want to automatically probably migrate or get your existing content from a classic pages or some of that content to the new experience. So using all of these methods which are now available, you can easily do that by running a code programmatically across all of the hundreds of thousands, potential hundreds of thousands of sites within your tenant. So really, really nice set of capabilities which are now available.
Yeah, and actually that would be a really nice community project as well, like a project for upgrading your classic homepages to modern homepages. So definitely.
Actually, Bert, on that one, I wouldn't say that it's a community project because using this code, you can actually do that. But then the community project would be having a more control and bigger, let's say, solution on top of it. But yeah, technically, anybody using this code can do that.
Correct. That's the point. So. Yeah. Okay, I switched to the code. I am in the provisioning.modernpages sample, which is in PNP. So if you go to the PNP repository, you will find this sample. And in here, for this demo, I commented out the previous demos. So in the previous webcast, we ran across these demos, so the basics. Whereas today, we're going to focus on the newer elements. So what we're going to do in the first step is create a client-side page with multiple zones. So let's press F5 to start this solution. It will ask me for a password. So let's, and it will stop on the first breakpoint. So what we're going to do over here is create a client side page with the name page-with-sections.aspx. So it's first step, which was already also available previously. The new thing is here is like adding a zone. So I'm going to add a zone to the page, a three column zone. So you have three equally sized columns. Then I'm going to add a zone with two columns. And you see the order that the second zone comes behind the first zone. We have a page with two zones, one with three columns, one with two columns. The next step, I'm going to add some web parts to that zone. Now for this demo, I've chosen to create a third party web part. It's a basic Hello World web part, like shown in the SPFX tutorial, which already installed to the site. So this web part is available. I'm going to find it. So I'm going to get all the available client side components. I'm going to look for my Hello World web part. And I found it. So good. So we have that one available. Before you ever use that web part, we're going to add a simple text control as well. So create a client side text control, add that to the page. Now you see in the add control method, you can now specify where to add the particular control. So in this case, it goes to page two, to zone zero, so the first zone. Remember that this zone had three columns. I'm not specifying a column, which means it will take the default column, which is the first column. So this goes to the leftmost column of the first zone. Okay, done. Then our third party web part, which we loaded previously, I'm going to add that one twice to this page. First, I'm going to add it with a configuration saying hello world from control one. I'm going to put this in zone zero. So the first zone in section two is the third column, the rightmost column of the page, of the zone, sorry. So that's there. Then I'm going to add the same part again with a different configuration, but now I'm going to put it in zone one, so the second zone. And again, there is no section, so it will end up in the first column. You might wonder, like, okay, how do I know how to set the properties? And there has been a nice change in the workbench. So if I go to my workbench, so here I have the localhost running workbench with my Hello World web part. So if you create your web part, you can always click on this web part data button and switch to classic pages to get a good look at what are the custom properties. Well, what are the custom properties that the web part is using? Sorry, let's do it again like this. So you see it highlighted text is the properties for this particular web part. By default, when you put web part on a page, it will use the properties that you gave it at design time. But if you want to change properties and create different instances having different settings, you can perfectly do that by looking at the properties like description. By default is Hello World, whereas we in our demo set description to Hello World from control one. So we can configure the web parts when you put them on a page. All right, almost done. Let's save this page. Saving, okay, done. And let's have a look to see if the page was actually created. So here I am in a regular modern group site. Let's go to the home page first, just to show you this is a standard modern group site. It has a custom theme applied, but besides that, it's the standard modern theme site. I'm going to go to pages. And here you see our new page called Page with Sections. So let's have a look at that page. It's loading. It loads the controls and you see already that things are on different places on the page. So let's put the page in edit mode. We'll make things more clear. So we had a three column zone as first. So you see the three columns. We put the text control in the left one, our custom third party web part in the right side. And then we put the same web part with a different configuration in the second zone in the left section or column you see over here. So that went okay. Also notice we have commenting. So one of the new features is having comments on pages, so you, people can use this to start a discussion on the page content. I'm going to discard these changes, and let's flip back to the demo. Okay, next demo, we're going to read the same page again. So I'm going to read it again, which gives me an in-memory representation of that page with its controls. You see the three controls on the page, one text, two web parts. Now, if you have multiple zones and sections, it would be nice to be able to move web part to a different spot on the page, which we can. So we have a move method over here, where essentially you can move a web part to a different location. So I'm gonna take the web part, which is living in the first zone, first section, first control, which is our text web part, and move that to the section two of the same zone. So actually to the rightmost column with order 20, so below the original one, which was the first part web part. So let's do that. Then I'm going to also switch the order of the zones. We had three columns first, then two columns. Now I'm going to turn that around. I want the two column zone being the first one. So I'm changing the order. Okay. And finally, I'm going to add a new control to the middle column. Save that one. Page has been saved. And third part of this demo is disabling the comments. Remember that the page had comments. Now you can, commenting is a new feature which you can disable at page level, which this particular API call is going to do. So disable comments will disable this for a particular page. So
and back over technically here, the comments can be controlled in a site level and a tenant level as well. But just a big quick note on that.
Yeah, absolutely.
But let's see how the page look like. That was a complex change.
That was a pretty complex change. Remember, envision you kind of being able to manipulate your pages like this, so it's pretty cool. So page in edit mode, just to show you the differences. So we have the two column as first, which was the last one previously. So that went well. It kept the custom configuration of the web parts. Everything nicely stays as is. We have our three column below. We have our new text control. And we see that the text control, which was living in the first column, now moved to the most right column as last control on the page. So you can actually stack different controls in one section and control the order of them or change the order of them as well. So you have full flexibility on dealing with the page. And finally, you see commenting has been turned off. So this switch has been programmatically turned off for you.
Now, practice, if you keep this on edit mode. So just to clarify what's actually happening here in the background is that the structure of the page is actually stored in a field within a pages list. And that field has a relatively complex HTML structure, which is then defining what is a zone, what is a column, what is a web part, what is the properties and all of that. And everything is stored within the column. So theoretically, you can absolutely do the same thing using the REST APIs as long as you crack the secret of the structure. But using the CSM APIs are provided to you here, you can see that it's really easy to use the managed code to automate operations. And maybe I shouldn't say this out loud, but probably at some point sooner or later, and it might be already when this video is getting out as well, there could be operations for PMP PowerShell to do the same kind of modifications within the pages. But let's see when we get that one done. The number one thing is to have that support anyway in the CSM core component.
Yes, that's the first step. And we definitely will have this in the provisioning engine and in PMP PowerShell over time. Absolutely.
Yes.
It's really needed to provision modern sites. Okay, going on with the demo. So we talked about the zones and the sections and how to move controls around. Great. Now, next part focuses more on different page types. So I want to start with a news page. Now, what is a news page and where does it show up? Let's actually go back to the site, to the home page. You see this default homepage, it has this first party web part, which allows you to create news. So when you click on add news, you create a page and it will show up here as an item in this list. So this will show the top five pages. Now you can do this using the UI, of course, but you can also do this programmatically. So what I'm going to do over here is create a new page. Give it a two-column layout. I'm going to put text control on it in the first column, all right, and the image control on the second column. So this is an out-of-the-box web part, out-of-the-box first part, the image web part that I put on the page with a particular configuration.
It has relatively complex properties, yeah. That's
true. Add the control, all right. Going to save the page. At this point, I have a regular client-side page, nothing special. Now, this page will be promoted as a news article. And you can do this with any client-side page that you have, even existing pages. If you want to have them show up in the news, you can simply call the promote as news article method. And voila, refresh this page. We have our news page popping up in the list. And if I click on this guy, it brings me to the news page, which is our two-column page with the text and the image, as simple as that.
In practice, once again, so again, this is a completely encapsulated by the PMP's CSAM core. You can have a look on the code how we actually do that in CSAM. If you need to do the same stuff using the REST API, it's just a matter of updating certain properties and fields within the pages list. But this is once again over simplifying the actual implementation for your code, so you don't have to worry about the underlying secrets or the implementation in SharePoint.
Well, in this case, it's a fairly simple implementation. It's essentially, indeed, as you mentioned, there is the page list item. And whether it's a news article or not, it's just a field in the page list item that you have to properly set with a value and a publishing date.
Yeah.
So, but using the API makes it more easy and fluent for you. Okay, again, the next demo. So we talked about zone sections, about news pages. Now let's talk about home pages. So a site, any modern theme site, has this particular home page. They're all the same. So, but what if you don't want this home page? What if you want to create modern theme sites with a different home page? Or like in the scenario Vesa mentioned in the beginning, you want to create a home page for your classic theme sites but then using a modern page. So you start again in a similar way. You want to create a client-side page. The only difference here is that you specify a layout type. So by default, all pages have layout type article. In this case, I'm specifying layout type home, which is the home page. Then everything is just the same as before. You can create a flexible layout. So I'm going to choose for three column. I'm going to add three text columns. Three text controls each in one column over here. So like this, I'm gonna save the page. At this point, I have a home page sitting in the system, but it's not showing up as home page yet. So if you would refresh the site, it's not being used. So the final step here is calling the promote as home page, which will tell the SharePoint site, like, you have to use this page, which is home underscore two, as your home page. If I now go back to the site and click on home, I have a three column homepage. So you, essentially, I hope the demo has shown you that anything is kind of possible. You can make really complex homepages with 20 sections, having different layouts and with a massive amount
adding
of controls.
Adding whatever content. Yeah,
you probably shouldn't do that from a performance perspective and maintenance perspective, but I think you can do whatever you want when it comes to creating client-side pages. So it's just...
And it's anyway, it's such a typical scenario that customers want to have their own standardized homepage, which is having some sort of a welcome to this site and welcome to Bird One site. This is our project site and these are the things and these are the instructions. So it is a relatively typical scenario. So no doubt this will be highly used API.
Yep, and final one. If you're doing a demo, you want to clean up stuff. So I'm gonna set back my default page, home to the HPX as a homepage. So it's again loading the page and then saying promote this homepage. And if I now go over here, home, I'm back to where I was.
Yep. So now a few questions. Right now we didn't actually cover this, but what if somebody has to check out in functionalities enabled on that list or the site pages list? Does it work with the modern pages?
That works as well. That's a good question, Vesa. So let's go to the client side page controls. I do have, I don't see it immediately, but there is a check-in option, I think it's in the canvas for the page. So page.
But basically, yeah, we don't actually need to have a look on that. That's absolutely fine. But it's the same classic SharePoint capabilities where if somebody enables the checkout, check-in, and the draft versions and everything, we can still do that using these APIs as well.
Yes. So if you would create like a page in the UI, if I go over here, pages, and create a new site page. And give it a name, save. I didn't click publish and the page shows up here in a not published state.
Craft status, yes. Craft status, it's 0.1 version. Yeah, right. Absolutely.
But then you can use the publish method on the page to actually publish it. So that's built in. It's not part of the demo, but yeah, definitely possible.
Yep, absolutely makes sense. Cool.
All right. Moving back to the slides. One last slide. I thought there were no slides anymore, but it's one last slide. All of this is explained in our MSDN guidance, which you can get over here. And Chris O'Brien did create already in March a nice blog post explaining the basic part, but the thing is still very relevant and shows some different samples on how to use this API to customize your client-side pages. With that, we're done from my part, Vesa. So,
yep.
Comments from your side?
No, not really. I think it's a great set of APIs, and it really helps to automate defining the default pages and defining default content on a site. And also the scenario which we talked about is migrating, let's say, or not migrating, transforming the classic SharePoint theme sites to be using modern experiences. So you can absolutely use these APIs to automate that across all of the sites. And no doubt that there would be a nice community project in thinking around that one as well to have some sort of a centralized solution where you can control the logic of migrating existing classic pages to modern experiences. Yeah. Because no doubt, if you think about the classic page structure, there was always two columns, three columns, and then there was individual web parts. You could theoretically identify what are the web parts and get the modern replacements of those and all of that logic implemented.
Define mapping rules between classic web parts, modern web parts, how to map one to the other, how to map the properties, and then indeed apply that on scale.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And then have a PowerShell which is eating up that definition and blah, blah, blah. Okay, there's a lot of opportunities there. But anyway, out of the course of the podcast. Cool.
All right, but, guys, thanks for watching.
I think that's it.
Yeah,
thanks for watching, and please give us feedback. If we're missing something, please let us know. I think it's covering the basic scenarios, and like mentioned, there will be additional webcasts probably on the provisioning engine support for all of these modern capabilities in the future as well, depending on when you're watching the video. But I think that's it, Bert. Thank you.
Yep. Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.